Regardless, the last piece of knowledge should be here, in Egypt, and after having evaded my guide, I have now found the symbols. It's time. Time to learn what is behind these strange connections and events. Time to find page 3. That's what I say.
An open desk drawer.
Wait, that's the one I just... No. That's the one, but the other one's empty. That's empty. But there's a... No, that's the... Still missing another page. I was hoping I would find another key inside the desk. Five letters. I don't know if it's like any of the words in here. Africa is 6 letters. Egypt. I think it's like, I'm thinking where it was is a clue. I moved the letters. Elfsten, Cholstones, Acorn. Acorn, maybe? There's the size of an acorn. Okay, let's zoom in. Yeah, I think it would be acorn.
Okay, Grandpa. I need a clue to unlock this box. So if you're here... Guess I'll have to work it out myself, then.
Oh, there's no C? There's A, F, L. Damn. Really thought it was acorn there. I had another key or a clue. A 5-letter word.
It's going to take forever to sort through all these. Grandpa sure did like his books.
Wait, let's zoom in here.
I have always loved the British countryside. It's a shame to be stuck in here on such a nice day. Not to mention all the memories. I have always loved the British countryside. It's a shame to be stuck in here on such a nice day.
There's no jump in this game. Otherwise I'd be trying to jump up the ladder here. Some of these scattered pages look pretty interesting, but I guess they're not what we want. We're missing one page, apparently. Can't help but think it's maybe inside the clock or something crazy like that, of which we need a key. If I were a key... I mean, there was one right here, but this doesn't have drawers or anything. Where would we put a key? Alveon is 6 letters.
Can't imagine it's been used much. Celtic myths and legends.
Celtic myths and legends aren't used much. Don't tell me I'm stuck. I guess the shorter the game is, the quicker you get stuck. Anything behind there?
must have played through the Adventures of Merida every single summer I was here.
The Adventures of Mad.
An open desk drawer. An open desk drawer. A desk drawer.
Oh! Paige, I missed that.
What's this?
I got distracted by this. Well, not that, but this.
An open desk drawer.
Alright, let's check out. We got all the pages now. Which one was I missing? Yeah. Starts here. The alchemical. Okay, page 3. Well, right, I was talking about page 3. The alchemical symbol of earth combined with the Chinese one for tree. While a trip has yet again gone well, and my research has once again led me to these symbols, I can draw no conclusion. I have spent most of my life researching these mythological connections, and yet again I reach my destination, and nothing. Almost as if this is all an extremely elaborate prank. I sometimes wonder if my daughter is right. Months, nay, years of planning, only to eventually find a symbol or shrine with another symbol, another riddle, and another clue. However, at the same time, it feels like I am so close to finding some... And then it cuts off. Huh. Look at that. I'm assuming these pages are in order. Well, this says journal page number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, and then journal page Elfston says number 5. Well, in any case, now I can do something with this.
He sure could draw, though. I should see if I can find the missing pages before moving this.
There's another page? Damn you. Okay, I'm back to square one again, though. I don't have a key. And I don't know what word that would be. I mean, I could just try random stuff, but that would be kind of not good for you guys.
Fairies by Brian Froud and Alan Lee.
There's a book there, I guess.
Celtic myths and legends.
More books.
The Hero with a Thousand Faces by Joseph Campbell. An old bicycle.
You know, I'm thinking... Where is this key?
Doesn't fit. That old man never could fix anything properly. There are four hands. That old man never... They keep... Grandpa loved this thing. Told me it was one of a kind. Although, he never actually told me why.
Well, we want to get in it, that's for sure.
These books... It's going to take forever to sort through all these. Grandpa sure did like his books. A desk drawer.
Crouching.
I guess Grandpa used... Nah. This will be perfect for
an open desk drawer.
Not seeing any keys here.
Magnifying glass. For magnifying things.
Maybe we're supposed to look through the magnifying glass and we'll see a word?
It's a magnifying glass. For magnifying things.
It only goes, yeah, I can't move it, other than...
It's a magnifying glass. For magnifying things.
Can't help but think, maybe we can see a word. By looking through it at the correct angle. I'm not getting anything here. I haven't looked at this thing. Oh, wait. Oh. Well, that did look weird. It looked like it was on top of... Maybe the clue is on the clock to open this thing. Maybe. I didn't really look at the hands and stuff. No, it's just Roman numerals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. When you look through this, though, it's funny because it looks like it's sitting on top of the table. I don't like this grandpa very much.
Fusang China. And a symbol of a tree. Oh, okay. These can be pushed.
I didn't know that. It didn't do that before, did it? Fusang China.
Is that supposed to be wind? I'm guessing it's wind. Does this globe have anything to do with Grandpa's message?
It popped back in. So I'm guessing that's not the next one.
What did the message say again?
Which message?
What did the message say again? The world is full of secrets?
The world is full of secrets. Just gotta find out which secret. Pariacaca?
Pariacaca, South America. And that looks like a drop of water.
Okay, it went in.
From the tallest tree to the deepest river.
Alright, so the only one not done then is Pele.
Yeah! I did it! This looks like... Is this a second part of my necklace?
Really?
This looks like... Is this a second part of my necklace? Whoa!
Whoa indeed, you picked up necklace part.
I don't think I'm getting any more out of this globe.
To look through your necklace, press V. That's what V stands for, because we saw it here. This was blanked out to prevent a spoiler. Now it says necklace V. Okay.
I don't think I'm getting any more out of this globe. Whoa. Serious whoa. I don't think I'm getting any more out of this globe.
Ooh. This is a special clock indeed.
There are four hands, and none of them are moving.
Something else is moving, though.
The key I have doesn't fit here. There are four hands, and that old man never could fix anything properly.
I wonder if anything else looks different under the... This is where the magnifying glass might come in. It's hard to see, though. Come in handy. Maybe.
It's a magnifying glass. For magnifying things.
Well, it's gotta be for something, maybe. Huh. I look outside.
Not to mention all the memories.
It looks like a painting that way. Alright, well, I still can't open that, and I think the key...
A desk drawer.
...is in here. What's our choices for letters? We have A, S, A and S. I wonder if it changes. Sarah? Yeah, I mean, it almost says Sarah.
Huh. This tin box looks fairly old. Damn. I was sure that would be it. Maybe I need something else to solve this.
Like what?
Oh! I should see if I can find the missing pages before moving this.
I wonder what pages are left. I mean, it looks like you can have a space for one more under here, but I'm not sure. I was sure it would be Sarah. It only starts with A and S, unless I leave something blank.
What could the combination be?
Looking for letters with A and S that might be, you know, have some significance and be five letters. Earth, but I can only have A and S. Egypt, but I really thought it was acorn, but we don't have C for that second letter. Not available. Pixie, but he says pixie, but that doesn't start with A and S. Wait, I wonder if it looks different through the necklace. Would this look different through the necklace? It's got like an iridescent or whatever ink.
Okay, Grandpa. I need a clue to unlock this box. So if you're here...
Huh.
Guess I'll have to work it out myself, then.
It is Pixie, then. Sweet. Heh. Meanwhile, the true thing, well, sort of, is blank, blank, R, blank, E. Key!
Whoa. Fancy key. Whoa. Fancy key.
Ornamental... I'm not on a time thing.
Okay.
A key with gold finish. Looks fancy. It feels strange in my hand, like it's electric almost. Also, the grandfather clock rang when I picked it up, so I guess they're connected. Like a remote control. With the key, the remote control of a clock. Near instinctively thought I had to reach the clock before it stopped ringing or something. Chiming. Alright, so what the hell are we doing here? Let's look through our little necklace then.
It weighs like 200 pounds. There is no way I can pick this up. Weren't these triangles in the journal pages?
Hmm.
This clock hand is a triangle facing outwards, with a line going through it.
Oh, just the hands we look at.
This clock hand is a triangle facing inwards, with a line through it.
Well, I can see the clock hands better if I just don't use the necklace for now.
This hand is a triangle facing outwards. This clock hand is a triangle facing inwards. This button seems to control what clock hand can be moved.
Okay. It controls what clock hand can be moved. So the question is, what?
This button seems to select clock hands. This button seems to control what cloth hand can be moved.
Okay. So what do I want to... This is the one with the, like, kind of drop of water? Journal page one, drop of water? We don't have anything like that.
Weren't these triangles in the journal pages? Weren't these triangles in the journal pages?
Yeah. There's the alchemical symbol of water. So we've got this one. It's not on this clock that we have something like that, but we got. So we have this. 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 And. Oh. So maybe we do start with this? It's a.
This button seems to select clock hands. This hand is a triangle facing outwards.
Oh my god. So what am I doing? And why am I doing it?
This button seems to control what clock hand can be moved. Aren't these- I probably need to select- This clock hand is a triangle facing- This clock hand is a triangle- Aren't these triangles in the journal pages? This clock hand. Aren't these triangles in the journal pages?
What'd she say? I probably need to select something?
This clock hand is a triangle facing inwards with a line through it. Aren't these triangles in the journal? This clock hand. Aren't these triangles? This clock hand is a triangle facing inwards. Aren't these triangles in the journal pages? I probably need to select a clock hand somehow.
Yeah. That's what she was saying. I thought she was giving me a hint, but I already know that. It's just I don't know what we're supposed to be doing.
It won't budge. Weren't these triangles in the journal pages? Button seems to select clock hands. I probably need to select a clock hand somehow.
I really don't know what to do.
This button seems to control what clock hand can be moved.
So we've got different hands. So maybe I'm supposed to align them based on what page I find it on. The thing is, these two are identical.
This clock hand is a triangle facing outwards, with a line going through it. Weren't these triangles in the journal pages? Weren't these triangles in the journal pages? This hand is a triangle facing outwards.
Facing outwards. So that's page one, and then page two. Facing outwards. Yeah. Okay, this is page 2 then. Can we move this? No, not yet. Well, maybe we can. Yeah.
Weren't these triangles in the journal pages?
Yes, they were. Oh, well, I'm moving that one. I wanted to be on 1, not 12. What am I doing? Okay, so then 3. I don't even know if this is the answer. So what's the difference between this and this? Okay. The triangle is facing inwards with that, with a line through it. Triangle facing inwards with a line through it. Is that what I want? That one.
This clock hand is a triangle facing inwards with a line through it.
So I'll make this page 3. And then... I guess it's not doing anything. Let's try my little... Maybe I have to line these up. Wait. Oh, got it. Not with the page numbers. Ugh. So this, okay, is the... That's on the first page. That's facing outwards. So I need to put it...
Okay.
Here.
So I need to set these hands correctly. Maybe the answer is in Grandpa's journal pages.
I just figured it out, game. I just figured it out. All right.
This button seems to select clock hands.
Just easier if I just stay there and just move it. Seems legit. Alright. Symbol of water. Well, that's the same as this. One's... Okay. They both look like drops, but one's solid, and one's... I might even not have the right one. No, okay. The solid one is there. That is... Triangle... Facing inward to the line. So... Where is it? It's somewhere around here. That's it. Okay. Grandpa is such a tricky old coot. Alright. So the earth, or tree one rather... Triangle facing inwards with a line. So, 3. Okay, so it's at the 6 o'clock mark. Triangle facing in with a line. Oh, wow, you really zoom in. Okay, so then finally, the swirl, which is like wind, like a whirlwind, is there. So the last hand goes there, facing outward. I have to go all the way around. Where is it again? That's like 2 o'clock?
Was that it?
Ooh.
Did I do it?
Back up from the clock, quickly!
Whoa! What's happening?
It absorbed her very essence. The end.
That was the first time I traveled by magic, pulling at the thread that would unravel my grandfather's mysteries. I so wish he told me sooner, so we could have gone on at least one adventure together. Instead, I went on his adventure.
Oh.
The one that never was. But that is a longer story. For another time.
For a sequel? Credits. So thanks so much for watching, guys. I enjoyed this. It's a nice little game. Seems like the most interesting part would happen right at the very end. But of course, we're limited to an independent budget, but we can use our imagination, can't we? Okay. Oh, Hallgren and Almgren. For some reason, at first glance, I thought it was the same name. So I want to thank you guys for watching. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. I'll be playing some somewhat longer things, as it is. Oh, free sounds. And as it is, I'm already playing some longer stuff. Some really long RPGs, as it is. So it's good to throw in a shorter little ditty now and then. Thanks again for watching, and see you guys in another Let's Play.